Armour and Company takes a chance. When I arrived in South Omaha, both Carnegie and the Omaha Packing Company felt that they could struggle along somehow without my services as a salesman. But the sales manager of Armour and Company, Rufus E. Harris, was a reckless man. He took chances. He hired me to sell bacon and ham and beef, canned meats and cheese to butcher shops and grocery stores in South Dakota. Armour had 27 traveling men selling Armour products in the Midwest. My salary was $17.31 a week, plus traveling expenses. When I wrote the thrilling news to my parents, they could hardly believe it. There had been periods on the farm when Father hadn't made that much in an entire year. Father warned me that Armour and Company couldn't keep on paying that much money very long. I feared he was right. My territory covered practically all of the state of South Dakota, from the Minnesota line to the Black Hills. For some unknown reason, every salesman who had tried to sell Armour products in that territory had failed. It now stood at the very bottom of the 27 sales territories handled by the South Omaha branch. That was the reason I got it. Within 2 years, I raised that territory from 27th place to first place. The day I received a letter of congratulations from my boss, saying, "You have achieved what seemed impossible," I had to go out and buy a bigger hat. 6 months later, when I was 22, Armour offered to make me manager of their branch house in Des Moines, Iowa. They told me I was the youngest man who had ever been offered such a position by Armour and Company. I didn't accept, because I had already decided to come to New York to study at the American Academy of Dramatic Arts. I was on the stage for 1 year. Let us pass over that year in the silence it deserves.